Unfolding the eternal excellences, the hidden insights of the truth, and the depth of the riches of wisdom and knowledge.
The Bible says, I have cleansed thee by the word. I have not pointed to your weaknesses. He says, I have cleansed thee by the word. I have pointed to your strength. And this is your strength, that I am Christ in you, the hope of glory.
The glory of freedom, the glimpses into eternity.
The gospel is not supposed to be an assumption. It's not supposed to be just a mere presupposition. Truth is older than language, but the word of God is way deeper than any human language.
And now, Apostle Grace with the Word.
Bible says in John chapter 7,
that in the last day, the great day of a feast, Jesus Christ, He cried out saying, If any man thirst, let him come and drink. He says, He that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of the belly, his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But the Bible says, but this he spake concerning the Spirit. He was talking about the Holy Spirit, which they that believed on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because Jesus was not glorified. Tonight I want to talk about the person of the Holy Spirit. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah, amen.
The Bible says the Spirit was not come, because Jesus was not yet glorified. That means the coming of the Spirit on all who should believe, for them to receive, came after the glorification of the person of Jesus. Who is the person of the Holy Spirit? The Bible speaks of the person of the Holy Spirit in Genesis. The Bible says in the beginning, the earth was without form. It was void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the water. And there was nothing yet formed, but he was present from the beginning. He's one with the Father, and he's one with the Son. God, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit are one. But he gave us the Holy Spirit as the existential person on earth for our proof that we are not alone. Tell your neighbor, I am not alone. Tell your neighbor, I am not alone. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In John chapter 16 verses 12, Jesus told his disciples, he said, I have yet many things to say, but you cannot bear them now. But he says that how be it, that he, when he, the Spirit of truth is come, he will guide you into all truth. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
For he shall not speak of himself. The Holy Spirit does not speak of himself. Whatsoever he shall hear, that he shall speak. And the Bible says, he will show you things to come. That means when a man understands the person of the Holy Spirit, the future is not a mystery.
inama.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Jirangu hallelujah.
And the Bible says he shall glorify me.
Baibu nejangu arjantimusa.
For he shall receive of mine.
Akubariya ya chira kuruka harini.
And show it unto you.
Abiboreke.
All that the Father has are mine.
Ebitata inebjona. Nejanchi.
Say I.
Now get some chong to langyowe.
But he shall take of mine.
And yakwara havyanchi.
And show it to you.
Abiboreke.
You want to know why the Spirit shows you?
Nuenda kumanya abwencho moyorkwela na kuoreka.
Because the Bible says,
akwa Bible nejira,
the hidden things are of God.
When it don't share it, when they are hanga,
but the revealed things belong to us.
Nevitu.
And our children.
Nala navitu ebrojona.
That means to God.
Eso sumeta ngwa haruhanga.
Revelation is possession.
Okshururwa nkokwachira nkokutunga.
What is revealed belongs. What is not revealed is not yours. Some people say confession is possession. But you cannot possess if it's not revealed. Regardless of how much you confess. The Bible speaks of such people and says that they worship me with their lips, but their hearts are far. It's one thing to speak. It's another to know who you're talking about. It's one thing to talk about him. It's another for him to turn up. Somebody shout hallelujah. It's one thing to some a believer who has the Holy Spirit. It's another thing for the Holy Spirit to be evident on your life. That you don't need to say. I want to talk to you about the power of the Holy Spirit. Can I demonstrate something? Let me point towards the choir. Look at that. Look at that. I'm just pointing. When you know him a certain way, you don't need to speak. You just point. And he's there. Because I know him. I said I know him. That was a finger. So imagine if I speak. Imagine if I bark. Imagine if I scream. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tell somebody, Holy Ghost. I thank you. Because I know you. He's the power that opens the blind eye. He's the power that opens the deaf ear. He's the power that gets cancer out of the body. He's the power that raises the dead body. He's the power that reconciles the broken. He's the power that heals the If you believe it, shout hallelujah.
Why not
you
choose that song, hallelujah?
Without him, we can do nothing.
I have tried it in the school.
But with him, I feel him. I feel him. By him the worlds were framed. Without him nothing was made that is made.
And
his mountains are leveled.
Valleys
are raised. Government
change.
People stop being normal men.
He
says the Spirit shall come upon you. And you shall turn into another man. You shall turn into another man. And the Holy Ghost is on you. You're bigger than your age. You're bigger than your status. You're bigger than your weight. You're bigger than yourself. I know the first time some people met me. They are expecting a very big man. A very old man. The spirit doesn't come because of age. The spirit does not come because of weight. The spirit is not available because of size. But you need him. Demons are leaving. Because that is the mystery of godliness. The Bible says that godliness is contentment. When you walk in the spirit of godliness, you're content. And the Bible says there is much gain.
Bible
says godliness with contentment is of great gain. The Bible says great is the mystery of godliness. So God was manifest in the flesh. He was justified in the spirit. Every man with the spirit of godliness is justified by the spirit. I don't need to be justified by a man who does not know him, who has never tested him, who does not know how much powerful he is, who has not seen him a certain way. My vindication is of the spirit, because I realized he was all I needed. Somebody shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. The believers believed one time. In Corinth. And in the book of Acts 19. Apollos was at Corinth. Paul passed through the upper coasts and went to
Ephesus.
Then he found disciples and he said unto them, have you received the Holy Ghost? Listen to the question. He didn't say, have you been given? He asked, have you received? It's not, listen, it's not a question of being given. God has given us the Spirit. It's a question of, have we received? This thing I'm talking about, it can be received. And it's available. Because Jesus is glorified. The Bible says before Jesus was glorified, the Spirit was not given. But when Jesus was glorified, the Spirit was given. So it's no longer on the giving. It's about the receiving. And what did they tell him? They said, we have not so much as heard whether there be any Holy Ghost. And he said unto them, what then were you baptized? And they said unto him, John's baptism. Then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe. believe on him who should come.
Which
is Jesus. That's the baptism of John. For people to believe on who is coming. Next verse. When they had this. When they had this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. And when Paul had laid hands upon them, the Holy Ghost came on them. And they spoke with tongues. And they prophesied. But this is the thing. Some receive little. When I decided to drink, I drank. I feel it. And I still drink. When I touch for the spirit, I don't drink cups. I drank from the river that flows. From the person of Jesus. The spirit is endless. To those who choose to take him fully. Remember.
Yusuka,
it's in the revelation of the word. For he reveals this thing. And in the spirit of revelation. As the spirit of revelation is spoken. Manifestation comes for things to belong. The Bible says he that is sent of the Lord. Speaks. The word of God. And the Bible says, for God giveth not the Spirit by measure to him. He doesn't give him a spirit by measure. No. God giveth him not the spirit by measure. When the spirit of revelation sits on you, you're not limited in the operation of the Holy Ghost. You have an anointing that is without measure. You're a body wholly filled and flooded with God himself.
No,
you don't sleep like a normal man. You don't sleep like a normal man. You don't function like a normal man. Somebody say in the name of Jesus. I refuse to function like a normal man. I refuse. You're going to drink today. God asks them, are you thirsty?
Akababuza ngumwiniro.
Pan Holy Ghost, no.
Man, come on your prayer again.
He asked them,
Akababuza.
Are you thirsty?
Mwiniro.
Come.
Mwise.
He said, come.
Ati mwise.
Let me say this.
Tekangambesi.
The Spirit of God responds to the degree of how much you know him. We all received him when we became born again. All of us. But he functions in different degrees upon all of us. His function is related to how much we know him. The Bible says he's bottomless. And he searches the bottomless things of God. He has revealed to us things I have not seen. He has not heard.
Has
not entered into the hearts of men. Because we love him. Some of you think your problem is poverty. Your problem is not poverty. You need the Holy Ghost in a certain dose. You need a certain anointing. Some of you think the problem is you have a problem in your marriage.
No.
You need a certain anointing. Some of you think your problem is sickness.
No.
You need a certain anointing. That's why the Bible does not say that the anointing shall break the yoke. Some people say that, but that's not what the Bible says. The Bible
doesn't
say that the anointing shall break the yoke. No. The Bible says the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. There is a difference. When you say the anointing shall break the yoke, you mean to say that the anointing deliberately to attack
okurumba
the yoke. The Holy Spirit is too big to deliberate. He's too big to attend to the devil. No. What he says here is that the yoke shall break, shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Let me explain what he means. Yokes were wooden pieces put under the necks of animals. You know, in the necks of animals. Like donkeys to walk together. Cows to
dig.
You know what a yoke is?
No,
and sometimes they used to put them on prisoners. What he's saying here, he says, the anointing increases and the yoke is broken because of the anointing. It means to say you invest time in receiving, in increasing the anointing. The yoke breaks. You don't increase the anointing to break the yoke. No, you increase the anointing because you want the anointing. And as the anointing increases, the yoke breaks. The anointing breaks everything that limits it. Even if it's not a yoke, even if it is a wall, the wall breaks because of the anointing. Poverty breaks because of the anointing. Sickness breaks because of the anointing. Somebody say, I receive it. The primary ministry of the anointing is to know God. The primary ministry of the Holy Spirit is to know God. The Bible says he shall teach you all things. As you learn God, the yokes break. The Holy Spirit does not teach you about the devil. Some people, they just teach about devils. This demon that does this. This demon that does this. And then they say, you know the truth. Truth is not in knowing devils. Truth is knowing God. When you know God, and His only Son Jesus, He created the devil. You don't be ignorant. You
will talk about Shema
on the devices of the devil.
Aha,
that's why he says, brethren, your obedience has come abroad upon all men. And now I would rather have you wise unto that which is good and simple, little about evil. I can't sit here and just tell you about the devil. I have a God. We have a God. We have the Holy Spirit. We have the person of Jesus Christ. When I got to know God, I asked him one question. Why is it that you're not moving in our generation? Like we used to read in the Bible days. Bible days are back. You see the lame walking. The blind seeing, tumors disappearing, and we are just beginning. Tell your neighbor, we're just beginning. And then the Lord told me, because people don't take time to know the person of the Holy Spirit. I took time and started East African revival. Edward Joe Church.
Edward Joe Church.
The gentleman in Gahini.
Oh,
I took time and read about the Nagendas of Kampala in Buganda.
The Chinookas.
The
Blasio.
The Biangwas.
Biangwa.
The Salitas in Rwanda.
Aba Rwanda.
Some of you must understand
that
we cannot fight the Holy Spirit and believe God for him to move. No movement has existed without the person of the Holy Spirit. But when the church loses the person of the Holy Spirit, pastors start ruling by politics. Bishops start ruling by politics.
But bishop batanka kwebembera.
Competition.
Hatanka kuba kuhayana.
Blackmail.
Hatanka kuba ho
gosheterana.
Hatanka kuba ho rugambo.
You need the Holy Spirit.
When
you have the Holy Spirit, you don't need to gossip. When you have the Holy Spirit, you don't need politics. Some on money. How do I benefit? When politics and money substitute the Holy Spirit, religion is bad. Some people want to be known by certain people. Because they have a connection with so and so, and then they know the other one, and then they know the other one. Because I know this one, I will not work with the other one. Well, me, I know the Holy Spirit. He's the only one I know. He's the only one I serve. And it's all I need. And those who have him and know him a certain way. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
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 We are believing God to remove this land has never seen. And there are people here ready to receive
you.
Hallelujah. not he's given, he's available.
Aruho.
But the question is, will you receive? I realized one thing. That for so long, we are walking off the path of the person of the Holy Spirit. And yet he is all we need. I know some of you are born again. But I beseech you by God, believe God for something you have never seen and tested and touched concerning the person of the Holy Spirit. I see prophets rising in this land. I see apostles. I see pastors. I see healing evangelists. I see the most successful people the world has ever seen. And they're here. Now I want you to get to your feet and raise your hands. And say one thing, Holy Spirit. I want you now than I've ever wanted you before. Open your voice and start to pray. Just open your voice and start to pray. Raise your voice and say, Holy Spirit, I need you. I need you. I need you. I need you. Tell him I need you. Tell him I am ready to receive you. In the heaviest measure. Raise your voice and start to talk to God. If you have never spoken in other tongues, they are coming right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, speak to God. Speak to God.
Gamba naruhanga.
Speak to God.
Gamba naruhanga.
Speak to God.
Gamba naruhanga.
If you're sick in your body,
waba rugiro mumubiri kwa.
Tell the Holy Spirit,
gambira moyo rukwera.
I want to receive my healing now.
Otinyenda kwa chiro kutsuka kwa nte hati.
As you ask him,
waba no msaba.
He's going to operate your belly.
Naza kusemezo munda.
He's going to heal your body.
Naza kususe mumubiri kwawe.
He's going to open your eyes.
Naza kuigura miso gawe.
Your ears.
He's going
to heal cancer. He's going to take HIV out of you. Come on, talk to the person of the Holy Spirit. Something is coming. 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 The Holy Spirit is here. The person of 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 the Holy Spirit is here. You're going to call on Jesus. Seven times. Seven times. And when you do,
come call at score.
A power.
A man.
Like you have never felt, is going to come upon your life. Did you hear what I say? We're
going
to call upon Jesus seven times. And on the seventh time, the power of God is going to come. Don't ask just for power. Ask for power.
Salaman
to change their generation.
Gahindire om sinjemgona.
Young people,
Iarato,
ask for your generation.
Savom sinjemgawe.
Your generation.
Omrembe gwawe.
Yes, ask for your generation.
Savom mrembe gwawe.
Oh God, I refuse to die
Gambela kamotini nyanga
without writing history. Young people on the ground. Pastors on the ground. Ministers on the ground. I want you to raise your foot and cry out to God. And tell him we need you. Tell the Holy Spirit one more time. This one more time. Touch me in a way that will change my life, to change the world. Are you ready? You're going to feel something you've never felt before. Get ready. Are you ready? I'm going to count as you call on Jesus. One. Two. Three. Four.
Ida.
Five.
Itano.
He's already started.
Yatan chile.
Six.
Mukaka.
Seven.
Sansu.
Receive him. Receive him. There are people on this ground that are going to change
Uganda.
Africa.
The
world. Put up your hands, everybody. If you are a prophet,
what nabi
called to the world.
Oh yes, well, I'm getting
right now.
Hansi.
The power of God comes upon your life to separate you.
Tansa.
Power it out.
Power
the Holy Spirit.
Touch
that prophet.
Watana po.
Touch that prophet.
Watana po.
Touch that prophet.
Watana po.
Touch that prophet.
Watana po.
Where are your prophets?
Abana po barai.
The ones you called.
Abu ayosire.
There are apostles here.
Are here to Maha.
Clap your hands, everybody.
We
are tired of seeing a church without the power. There are apostles on this ground.
Are here to Maha.
If you are called,
wow, yes,
in an apostolic office,
the
power of God
separates
you now. Now. The evangelists here. Miracles, signs and wonders are going to follow you. Evangelists, wherever they are,
Power of God,
Power of
God,
Power
of
God,
Power of God, Amen.
Pastor.
Abarisa.
Yours is coming now.
It's out again, Jesus.
Pastor.
Abarisa chan.
Oh my God, I feel it. I feel it. If you're a pastor,
what your marisa?
And you're in this ground,
what yaha?
You're going to see a ministry.
That
you've never seen on Africa. Right now, in the name of Jesus.
Come on,
go. Come
on, go. Come on,
go.
Amen.
Teachers. God is anointing you. He's anointing you. He's anointing you. If you're a teacher on this ground, come and raise your hand. The spirit of revelation is settling on some people right now. Come on now! Come
on,
Holy Spirit! Touch somebody. Separate that person. In the name of Jesus. 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 Nations are opening. For some people on this ground, I don't need to call you out. The spirit is coming now. Now. You will never forget this day. They stumbled on this ground. The world has been waiting for you. Northwestern Uganda. The world. Not Kampala. The world. Not Africa.
Africa.
The world.
Bobo,
you go! You're sick in your body. Raise your hands right now. The healing power of God is starting to move. Again.
Ogunda Muruni.
Again.
Ogunda Muruni.
Receive your healing.
Yachiro kusizu baba.
Belem walk.
Abarema no tambura.
If you're on your bed.
Wawo jaya buri.
Get off your bed.
You can't stand.
Get off your bed now.
You can't stand.
Get off your bed now.
You can't stand.
Start to do something.
Tandika kore.
You could never do.
Esu wata kora.
Jesus has healed you.
Yes, he has
healed you. Jesus has healed you.
Yes, he has
healed you. Jesus has healed you.
Yes, he has
healed you. Their ears are opening. Blind eyes are seeing. Tumors are disappearing. In the mighty name of Jesus. Demons are living. Witchcraft is living. Witchcraft is living. Witchcraft is living. There are people here on this ground. You were Muslims. And majini have been following you. Now every majini on this ground. I arrest you now.
Come
out. Come out.
Shut up.
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 In the name of Jesus. I want to pray for your family. Your homes. Your home. Your family. May God change your house. May God change your father's house. May God change your mother's home. Somebody talk to God about your family.
Say,
God, we need salvation for our family. In the name of Jesus.
Tell
Him, God, we are tired of poverty. We are tired of sickness. We are tired of disease. We are tired of bondage. We are tired of witchcraft. Change our home. God is changing your family. God is changing your home. In the mighty name of Jesus. Swellings are disappearing. Any kind of swelling. It is disappearing. Now if you're here. And you've never given your life to Christ. And tonight you heard me speak. And you feel you need the person of the Holy Spirit. He cannot come until Christ is glorified in your life. Wherever you are, put up your hand. If you want to receive Jesus
today,
you're going to repeat these words after me. Say, Lord Jesus. Today. I have believed your word. I have received your testimony. I believe with my heart. And I confess with my mouth. That you died and rose again. That you are Lord.
You are Mukama
and Savior.
Kandom Juni
of my life.
Wamakaraganji.
I'm born again.
Najunwa.
The message you have just heard was brought to you by Sinero Ministries International. For more information, contact us on telephone number 041-466-4291 or email us at finerokampala@gmail.com. You can also find us on the web at www.finero.org. Or better still, feel free to join us every Thursday for our weekly fellowship at Uma Multipurpose Hall from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. You can also catch the live stream at livestream.com/finero. Finero, make manifest.